Hey guys, so welcome back. So today we're looking at the quick shots from the DJI Mavic Air. We're looking at the specifics of the Helix double tap. We're gonna put all that into Final Cut Pro coming up. Now I want to go into my quick shots. And I want to go into Helix. And then I want to double tap, or I want to tap the Helix button again. See how it comes up at 40 meters? And you can tap this out to 65 meters. Just to kind of give you guys a, you can go up to, I think it was 200 meters. And it seems like the Helix has different characteristics than when it does this from ground level. When you're on the ground level and I put the Helix on myself, it kind of does an upward spiral. This one is not the same shape, but that's fine. It's I kind of actually like the uniqueness of the shot. And there's lots of things that you can do in post with that shot, so I'm just gonna leave it as is. Okay guys, so welcome back. So we are in Final Cut Pro. So I've got three clips here on the screen that I want to show you, and I'm gonna make this really quick. One clip going around the clock tower here, the bell tower. Another one going around this traffic circle, and then another third one that is just kind of a nice up and down shot. If you're new and you're not familiar with some of these tools, if you go to, basically if you highlight your clip here, and if you select B, turns your little mouse into a kind of like a razor blade icon. And that's what allows you to clip these into multiple clips. So that's the simplest thing you can do, and that works. So you could, in theory, clip this into four different things and then go up here to your speed ramp tool and go a little bit faster, a little bit slower. That kind of works. That's kind of the way I had done things in the past. But I came up with a better option here probably about a year ago. And so what you can do is, instead of hitting B, hit Shift B. Right, so when you hit Shift B, it'll basically put a marker right here, and so you want to have your little player head exactly where you want the shift to take place. And let's just kind of look at this first clip in detail. So I'm kind of zooming in here on this bell tower, and I kind of want to just go back and forth to what feels right. So what I like to do is I like to kind of start slow for maybe 1 second when I start my clips. Hit Shift B. Puts my little marker there, and then the next spot is going to be the part where I'm going to ramp, and I'm just going to kind of go back and forth to where it kind of feels right. So I'll say right about there. Maybe I'm going to do another Shift B, so that puts another segment here, and then I could just do a little another 1 second or so. Shift B, and then kind of a quick spin around, and then maybe another one there at the end. All right, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 little sections here. And what you want to do is, on these larger sections, these are the parts that you want to compress and speed ramp. And the cool thing about Final Cut Pro is you don't need any other plugins here to do this piece. You just basically take your mouse and squish this down basically as far as it can go. And you can always go back and undo that if it's too much. And take the second one, squish that one down. All right. So let's just take a look real quick and see what that looks like. Pretty sweet little zoom. So let's just do another one here we'll just do these last two here. And again, I like to just kind of take the player head and just kind of go back and forth to figure out where exactly I want this to take place. You know, so let me just trim a little bit off, use my blade tool, get rid of that, take a little bit more off. And these are like 20 second clips. So now this one's down to 21 seconds. And I try to keep these to, see this, even this is like 6 seconds. I really try to keep these down to like 5 seconds or less, just because people just don't have a long attention span these days. So, all right, so Again, I'll do a shift B, just coming in, and then I want to go quick little speed ramp up to the traffic circle, B, shift B again, and I'm going to do a blade tool here just to end the clip and just trim off the rest. All right, and then I'm going to take this and then squish that down. So now this clip is 3 seconds. All right, so it plays and then bam. All right, that could be compressed a little bit more. So I'm going to take my command plus to zoom in a tad. And we're just going to, sometimes it won't compress all the way down initially, so sometimes you have to go back in. So let's try that. So now we are at a 2 second clip. So that's pretty cool. Nothing miraculous there, but it helps you save your footage, because nobody really wants to see a 25 or 30 second constant video clip. Okay, so next, what I did here is, this was actually a rising shot, but I want to actually use this in the video to kind of where I'm coming down and kind of where I transition from the quad to myself speaking. So in my mind, it makes sense to kind of come down. So what I need to do is click this video clip, and then I want to do reverse. All right. Luckily for me, there's no cars here, so it doesn't really matter. You can't see any cars. Just nice wide open street, so it doesn't matter if it's in forward or reverse, it looks the same. And what we're going to do here is do the same thing, just kind of where it feels right. Quick little shift B at the front. And this one I'm just going to make it simple, just do a shift B at the front and a shift B at the back. And I'm going to compress everything in the middle. And the cool thing about Final Cut Pro is it does this very, very smoothly. So it's not, you're going from 100% of the speed up to 2,000% just like that. It gradually ramps it up. And most other editors, you have to do some kind of keyframing to do all to make a nice gradual line. And honestly, I just would never really take the time. So that's pretty much all there is to it, guys. Then you can add a little, you can add a little bit of music to that, and put the beat maybe where the, where the turn points are, or where there's like actual action instead of just panning, where if you turn, add some beats there. But just play around with it. That part's kind of the creative part of it. But these speed ramps are super simple, and here's what the end product looks like.